Hey YouTubers, it's Corey here. I am in Georgetown, Texas, getting ready to do what I believe is three rooms, a hall, and a master closet that's fairly small. So I'm gonna turn the camera around and we're gonna do a little pre-inspection and see what things look like. All right, this is the living room here. Show where the furniture was at, where it's furniture and a rug was at, and you see where most of the soil is at. I think part of that's probably a shadow. The hall, not too bad. One room here that's not bad at all. And then there's a master here with a carpeted bathroom. Everybody's favorite. Everybody likes a carpeted bathroom. And a little closet. There's another little closet over here that until it had no foot traffic. This is where everybody was at. Alrighty, well, I'm gonna go grab my stuff out of the vehicle and come back in and start cleaning, and I will update the video here in a second. carpet is, apparently there was like a cat or something. You can barely see it with the camera, but there, it's digging up. The machine is orbiting and it's digging up some kind of, lint or something to this nature. It's pulling that out of the carpet. So how that works is you let the carpet dry just a little bit, and then you come back and you vacuum it right before you leave. Luckily it dries in a hurry, so you can run the vacuum over it. See what you guys can see here. Thank you. All right. You still can't see the lint so much. Let's see here. Like right here. Here's a good, when you zoom in. What that is that's a fine cat hair. So when the machine is orbiting through the carpet, it's moving the fibers aside and it balls it up in little balls and then throws it. Now this is, it's already been vacuumed. So the way that works is they get down below the carpet fibers and tangled within the carpet fibers and you can't vacuum them out. But when the machine runs across it, it digs it out and it dries and then you vacuum it up and it's gone forever. This method for hair removal works better than steam. You can to some degree rinse hair out of carpet, but the problem when you're using steam, you're hitting it with about, depending on how dirty the carpet is, 300 to 400 PSI. So you're first blasting it down a little deeper, and then you're hoping you can vacuum it out. So whatever you don't get out, you jam it in a little deeper. So at least you hide it. This method here, it digs it to the top and you get to deal with it, which is not really all that much fun. It's kind of one of the drawbacks of this method is the fact that you dig up everything in sight. But once you dig it up and vacuum it out, it's gone forever until the cat sheds more and your vacuum misses it. All right, well, I'm gonna move to the next room or two here and set up and clean some more. Thank goodness for image stabilization. All right, we're gonna take a quick look here. This is the only room left to go here. So, take a look, we did the hall. We did this room here. And this room, I didn't dig up any cat here. So cat didn't live in here. It stayed in the bedroom all the time, it looks like. Then over here in the bedroom, just to ensure that it would be dry, I put two turbo fans out just so I'd know it'd be dry when I hit it with the vacuum. I pick everything up. All right, I'm going to clean this one now, and I will check in here again when I'm just about finished. All right, it's the last room. It's all pre-sprayed. I didn't show it because I had a neighbor walk over. I'm in a retirement community in Georgetown, and the retirement communities are generally, you know, the neighbors, they look out for each other. So the neighbor come across the street and walked all across my clean carpet to introduce himself. And so it's just, it's people looking out for people. It's good. It's a good thing, you know, but a little nosy, but all's well. So, and I'm going to clean this one down. I'm going to put the camera, I think, low at this time. So you can see the machine running. We'll start over here where it's dirtiest, I believe. This carpet's pretty wet because the wetter it is, the more soil you can move. So we're going to set it about that angle. careful with tiles wet.
You look back about a year, there's a video where I was cleaning some tile. I was holding my phone and I fell down right on my back. I was so pleased that I didn't curse. It was kind of hurt. It's some tile cleaning video. I look back pretty far. There's about 600 videos on my page so far. All right, so this part's been cleaned here. Now, I'm gonna do the rest. I don't know where to put the camera exactly. Let's maybe try it from a different angle. And I want to thank the people that watch all the time. Jay and Joe Wheeler watch all the time. Walter DaCosta out of Canada watches all the time. I'm always getting a lot of comments from a guy that goes by the name Philo Beto, and that is assuming he's a huge Clint Eastwood fan. I am. And a woman named Janet, I believe, she had some comments about feeling like I didn't change the towel out enough, so I'm going to have to show some videos of me changing the towel out too, so people know that I changed the towel out. A lot of times, you know, in a house like this, it's three rooms, it's not that overly soiled, so the towel will hold it all. If you're doing a restaurant or something that's just terribly dirty, you can tell when, by the effectiveness of the cleaning, when the towel is jammed and it can no longer hold any soil. So, you know, the main thing is to make sure that I've done the best job I can possibly do for the client, and I do change the towels out when necessary, but you know, my wife appreciates it when I don't bring a lot of laundry home for her to do. She's a full-time accountant, works a lot, and you know, I do the carpet cleaning, she's an accountant, and she washes the towels when I bring them home, and you know, the less towels I bring, I think the more she appreciates, because I sure appreciate her doing the towels for me. All right, I'm gonna set this down and see what kind of footage we can get here. All right, here we go.
I just got a call from a YouTuber right now. Jay, I will call you back. I'm right in the middle of making this video right here. You'll see this tonight. I'll call you back in about 20, 30 minutes here when I'm done. Good buddy.
Now we're going to take the Grandy groomer and we're going to groom the carpet. See what that looks like. I'm starting to kind of watch my own videos a little bit now. Curious to see what it looked like when I work. Never saw people work before. Focus here. Thank you. Alright guys, last thing to do here is to take my Dyson here and go vacuum up the lint in the bedroom. That's what we're going to do next. Alright, I got something I got to share with you guys because it's not just about carpet cleaning, it's kind of like a vlog. There's a mystery person outside in the driveway. I don't know who this guy is, but he picks now to show up. Hang on. Turn the other way. See if I can sneak over there. Give you guys a look at this dude. There you go. It's pretty odd. Been doing this since 2001. First time it's ever happened. Some random guy pressure washing the driveway. Okay, with an electric. Clearly not a contractor. All right, I'm gonna vacuum this now. Take a look at it while I vacuum. Done here. Take a look at the other room that I just did. Alright, well I've got to put up my tools now and go to the next job. I've got a stretching job next and I've got to find a way to get all my tools out of here without traipsing through the driveway that he's pressure washing as I clean my carpet. I don't know. Kind of a strange situation here. Alright guys, I appreciate you watching. Corey Thibodeau with CarpetMuscle.com in Austin, Texas, 512-350-1129.